Mayor Bowman, good afternoon, and congratulations.
Well, thank you.
This is one of those situations where you announced today that you're not going to run for re-election. Rare in politics simply because you generally will wait to the last minute for doing that. So take us through the thought process here, because I think pandemic has changed a lot of people. And I know that you spent a lot more time with family this summer and kind of reflecting on where you would go in the months and years ahead.
Well, thanks, Richard. And I appreciate the recognition that, typical political strategy would be you wait until the final months. And, you know, I've always thought that if I had the honor of serving as Winnipeg's 43rd mayor, two terms is a long time in politics. You know, looking at running again, you know, for me, that starts to feel like a career politician. And that's not something that I think Manitoba doesn't need more career politicians. And so, you know, I'm still here for 2 years. I'm going to continue to work really hard. But I want the community to have the benefit of time so that the 44th mayor of Winnipeg is someone with the integrity and the work ethic that Winnipeggers deserve. And 2 years notice, you know, primarily I just want to be honest with people, and I want to get the leaders out there that maybe wouldn't have thought about running against an incumbent mayor, because it is difficult. I want them to start thinking about it, start having those conversations with families and friends about what you would do to improve the lives of Winnipeggers and our community. And I'm confident Winnipeggers will get a good mayor.
I'm wondering if this is another way to maybe take the political shackles off, because let's be honest, when you're making decisions, you're not going to make everybody happy. The goal is to make the fewest number of people unhappy and get reelected. And so does this really get you, give you an opportunity to focus on what you'd like to achieve for Winnipeg without having to worry about how that will play in the public? You can really just focus on what you truly believe is the most important thing for Winnipeg moving forward.
Julia, I appreciate that question too, because I mean, I've tried to always operate that way. I've tried to just be honest on issues and speak from the heart. You know, not everybody will agree with different positions, but I hope folks can appreciate that I'm here for the right reasons and I'm just trying to move this community forward. And right now the focus is absolutely on pandemic. I want people to know, especially during the pandemic and in the coming years, that I'm focused on them and I'm not focused on re-election. And if that dynamic that you described in your question occurs, then, you know, we'll see. You know, I've tried to be open and honest, but we'll see how things go over the next couple of years.
What did your wife Tracy say when you made this joint decision?
Well, we've talked about this really since 2014. You know, we never aspired to have me become a career politician.
Understood. So, but are you done with politics after this is done? Or are you going back to the private sector?
Oh yeah, I'm in the best political job. If I wanted to stay in politics, I'd stay right here. You know, the power of incumbency. I benefited from it in the last municipal campaign. I'm not, don't expect me on a provincial or federal ballot in the near future or ever. I guess you never say never, but I don't have any desire to be a career politician. So yeah, I'll go back to a career outside of elected office.
1 minute left here. What do you believe, in addition to pandemic, is job one at City Hall? Because it's time now to really focus and get stuff done. What, in your view, needs to get done?
Yeah, I appreciate that, because our work isn't done as a council. I mean, nobody on council right now has an entitlement to their seats. We all have just 2 years left right now. Other than pandemic, it's infrastructure. It's the North End Sewage Treatment Plant. It's continuing to fix our roads and also modernize our public transportation system. Those are big priorities in addition to a lot of other files.
Mayor Bowman, we'll be talking again, I'm sure.
You bet. Thanks, guys. Have a great weekend.
Winnipeg Mayor Brian Bowman joining us live on 680 CJOB. More on the Bowman story just ahead, live at 5 is coming up.